the Great Tribulation so much more us. And when the Great Tribulation starts, I think we will see the start of it, and then God will take us away. Because the war, the Third World War, which is part of the seals, the third seal, that'll go off and just horrible things will happen. There'll be no electricity, a lot of technical things will stop, and you won't be able to do them anymore. It'll become very, very simple, and all these other things will be created. And they're already in the process of that they're creating these robotic dogs to do things and other robotic things. One of my visions of the future, I've seen a robot shooting fire at people. And it was just throwing fire on them. And the old lady from 1940s who gave a prophecy of what it would be like, it would be worse. There'd be no dignity left in the world. People would be walking around in their underwear almost, which is so true to this day. And that compared to World War II, World War III, compared to World War II, World War III, World War II was child's play compared to what World War III would be like. So if you just think of all the events that happened in World War II, that was child's play. You know, and then it's going to be a scary time to be in. It's going to get worse and worse and worse and worse. And darkness is just going to flood the earth. That, for us, is God's chosen righteous ones. We're going to be suffocating because of the evil and wickedness. That's going to be there. So I think we're going to see the start of it. And then he'll take us away in that last moment. He'll take us home. But we'll see the start of it, I think. Because I had another vision of the bride. And she was crying. And the Lord was comforting her. And she saw horrible things. But then the next moment, the last moment, he took her within a flash, within a blink of an eye. She went home. So that's how it's going to be. But we'll see destruction. We'll see the start of it. But then God will take us home. Because he doesn't want the ones who are chosen for him, who are trying to be holy, who are trying to be pure for him, who are obeying all his commands and ordinances. He doesn't want them to go through the tribulation. He doesn't want them to be there while his wrath is taking place. He wants them in the safety of his garment, out of the way. He doesn't want to harm them, because they're like precious jewels to him. And they're so precious to him that he wants to keep them safe and not wish any harm on them. But the ones who are wicked, it's like they're scratching the jewels. And you can't let that happen here longer, because those jewels are precious to him. He wants to stop them being squashed. He wants to take them away from that, so that they can be healed from those scratches and find